Good morning, everybody. How are you today?
Fine, thank you. And you?
I'm fine
today. Thank you. I'm fine and I'm very happy. I'm happy to see you again. Are you ready to start our session? Yes? Okay, good, excellent. Did you take your breakfast? Yes? Good, excellent. So now you're ready to start. Good. Okay, children, before we start with our session, with our reading session, I want to tell you something, okay? I want to tell you something in Spanish that is very important, okay? So listen to me, please, pay attention. Okay, bueno, pues el día de hoy quisiera platicar con ustedes acerca de dos puntitos o dos cuestiones importantes. La primera es agradecerles con todo mi corazón el detalle que tuvieron conmigo del cariñito del Día del Maestro que me hicieron llegar a través de la mami del salón, de una de las mamás del salón. Niños, les agradezco muchísimo el detalle que tuvieron conmigo. Los quiero mucho a todos y los llevo aquí a todos, miren, aquí en mi corazón los llevo a todos, pero no quería dejar pasar la sesión de hoy sin antes agradecerles mucho ese detalle que tuvieron conmigo. Me hicieron que pasara un día muy feliz, un Día del Maestro muy feliz, así es que muchas gracias a todos de todo corazón. Los quiero mucho. ¿Ok? Muy bien. Y, bueno, ya después de haberles comentado esto, que la verdad me llenó el corazón de alegría y me hizo muy feliz ese detalle que tuvieron conmigo, quisiera que retomáramos así, rapidito, para no llevarnos mucho tiempo de la sesión, la reflexión del día de hoy. ¿Sí? La reflexión del día de hoy que tuvieron con Miss Jessie, que tuviste la oportunidad de ver en el video con Miss Jessie. Entonces, no sé quién quisiera compartirme, pues así, de una manera resumida, de qué trató la reflexión de hoy, porque es importante rescatar la máxima y el compromiso. Pero antes de aterrizar en eso, primero tenemos que ir a... ¿Qué nos decía la historia? A ver, Isaac.
Listo, ya voy.
Muy bien, Isaac, te escuchamos.
Se trataba de un águila así ya muy grande y de un águila bebé o niño.
Sí,
y
le llaman aguilucho.
Sí, un aguilucho, y era de que subían a una montaña así muy alta, ¿no?
Ajá.
Y también de que le dijo el águila,
sí,
a Aguilucho de que saltara, pero el aguilucho no quería. Porque pensó que le iba a hacer algo porque pensó que le iba a pasar algo malo.
Exacto.
Y después se bajaron ya al suelo. Y ahí el aguilucho les contó que el siguiente día iban a ir a volver a que intente volar, pero ajá, que sus amigos del aguilucho dijeron que no podía.
Ajá. Muy bien.
Y de que fueron, pero se echó un chipotón, ¿no?
Ajá, exacto, ok, muy bien. Ok, Isaac, muy bien, muy bien. Tienes razón, Isaac. Gracias, Isaac. Puedes apagar tu micro. Fíjate bien, tiene mucha razón Isaac en lo que cuenta, ¿verdad? Esta es la historia de Papá Águila, del Papá Águila y de su pequeño hijo Aguilucho, ¿verdad? Y esta historia nos narra cómo el papá le pedía al Aguilucho que volara, ¿verdad? Le dijo, quiero que mañana subas a la montaña más alta y vueles, ¿sí? Quiero que emprendas el vuelo. Pero ¿qué sucedía con el Aguilucho? Tenía miedo, ¿verdad? Tenía miedo de volar. Él pensaba, ¿y si me caigo? ¿Y si no lo logro? ¿Y si algo me pasa? ¿Sí? Entonces él tenía mucho miedo de hacerlo. ¿Y qué sucedió? Pues se dejó llevar por los consejos de sus amigos, ¿verdad? Se dejó llevar por los consejos de los demás. No haz esto. Ay, no, mejor haz lo otro. No, te conviene mejor esto, ¿verdad? Y prefirió seguir los consejos de sus amigos que escuchar a su corazón, lo que su corazón le decía. ¿Sí? Pero al final, ¿sí? Se dio cuenta que realmente sí era capaz de volar, ¿verdad? Los amigos le dijeron, él les dijo a sus amigos, fíjense que mi papá quiere que yo vuele, que me suba a la cima más alta de la montaña y emprenda el vuelo, les dijo él, pero yo tengo miedo y si me caigo, si algo me pasa, y los amigos le dijeron, ¿sabes qué, Aguilucho? Si tienes miedo, pues inténtalo mejor desde la copa de un árbol. El árbol no es tan alto como la montaña, así si te caes no te va a doler. Entonces el aguilucho siguió los consejos de los amigos, se subió al árbol y ¿qué pasó? Pues nada, que quiso volar y se cayó. Y se hizo, como dice Isaac, un chipote, ¿verdad? Porque no logró emprender el vuelo. Después el aguilucho fue con el papá y le dijo, ¿ves, papá? Te dije que no iba a poder lograrlo. Y el papá, ¿qué le contesta? Le dijo, no. No me has entendido. Tú tienes que ir a la montaña más alta porque la montaña tiene la altura necesaria para que cuando tú te lances, el aire pueda entrar por tus alas y puedas desplegar tus alas y puedas volar, ¿sí? Tiene la altura suficiente. Entonces, lo intentó el aguilucho desde la cima de la montaña al día siguiente y finalmente, ¿qué sucedió? Pues lo logró, volar desde la cima de la montaña. Entonces, ¿qué quiere decir, niños? ¿Cuál es el mensaje? Pues que a veces nosotros no tomamos riesgos, nos dan miedo ciertas cosas, ¿verdad? Y nos da miedo arriesgarnos a hacer cosas nuevas o nos da miedo arriesgarnos a hacer cosas diferentes. Y nos cuestan trabajo, ¿verdad? Esas cosas nuevas o diferentes, nos da miedo. Y preferimos quedarnos en nuestra zona de confort. ¿Qué es tu zona de confort? Pues que prefieres quedarte ahí, donde estás, a gusto, sin intentarlo, ¿sí? Por miedo muchas veces, y es válido muchas veces, es normal tener miedo, ¿verdad? Pero lo que nos dice la reflexión es que tenemos que luchar por nuestros sueños, y para poder luchar por nuestros sueños, nos tenemos que arriesgar. Como dice un dicho por ahí, el que no arriesga, no gana. Entonces, si no luchamos por lo que soñamos, si no luchamos por lo que queremos, pues nunca vamos a poder cumplir nuestros sueños y nunca, fíjate, peor aún, nunca vas a poder saber si realmente eres capaz de hacer algo, porque nunca lo intentaste. Entonces nunca vas a saber si eres capaz de lograrlo realmente. Entonces, ¿qué te dice la reflexión de hoy? Hay que luchar por nuestros sueños, aunque a veces nos tengamos que arriesgar, ¿sí? Hay que luchar por lo que queremos, aun y cuando esto implique que nos tengamos que arriesgar, que va a haber riesgos. Pero la recompensa al final va a ser mucho mayor, ¿ok? ¿Quién me puede decir cuál es la máxima? Ok, Emiliano. La máxima.
Lucharé para cumplir y lograr mi sueño.
Excelente, Emiliano. Ese es, pero ese es el compromiso. Muy bien. El compromiso es, hoy lucharé, muy bien, Emiliano, hoy lucharé y me esforzaré por cumplir o por lograr, aunque sea una parte de mis sueños, ¿sí? Excelente. Ese es tu compromiso. Piénsalo, analízalo. ¿Qué puedes hacer desde ahorita? ¿Qué puedes ir haciendo para lograr tus sueños, para lograr lo que tú quieres hacer? ¿Sí? Para esforzarte. ¿Qué puedes hacer? Esa es la tarea que tú tienes hoy. Pensar qué puedes hacer. Y la máxima, ¿sí? A ver, Megan, ¿cuál es la máxima, Megan? Si tú recuerdas.
No tenerle miedo a mis sueños.
Muy bien. Exactamente, Megan. A lo mejor no viene con esas palabras como tú las estás diciendo, pero eso es. No tenerle miedo a mis sueños, o sea, creer en ti mismo. Cree en ti mismo para poder cumplir y lograr tus sueños. Entonces, para poder cumplir y lograr tus sueños, lo primero que tienes que hacer es creer en ti mismo. Porque si no crees en ti mismo, será muy difícil que lo puedas lograr. ¿Ok? Excelente. Entonces, acuérdate de tu compromiso del día de hoy. Hoy vas a pensar qué puedes hacer desde donde estás, desde tu casa, con la gente que te rodea, con las personas que te rodean. ¿Qué puedes hacer para empezar a luchar por cumplir tus sueños? Muy bien. Excelente. Espero que les haya quedado claro el mensaje que nos dice la reflexión el día de hoy. Muy bien, ahora sí vamos a iniciar nuestra sesión. Let's start our session. And to start our session, let's pray in the name of the Father, of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us remember that we are in the holy presence of God. Let's adore Him. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be the name, the kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Saint John Baptist LaSalle, pray for us. Leave Jesus in our hearts forever. I will continue, oh my God, doing all my actions for your love. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay, children, and remember discipline in our session, okay? Discipline is very important. I want to congratulate all of you because your microphones are off. Excellent. And that's one of the most important rules. Remember, your microphone off and your camera on. And I want to congratulate you because all the microphones are off. Excellent. Okay, so to start our session, children, I want you to take your student book on page 137, okay? Go to your student book and open it on page 137, okay? Today, you are going to learn a reading topic that is how to summarize. How to summarize, okay? I'm going to share a screen with you. I'm going to share a slide with you. Just give me a minute. Okay. I want to share this page. from the student book with you, okay? And today we're going to learn how to summarize. Well, but first, you are going to learn what is to summarize, okay? And I need a volunteer who can help me to read, Genaro. Can you help me, Genaro, with this, with the information from the box? Summarize, please.
After we read a part of a text or a story, we can summarize that we read. This means that we can write or talk about the mail. Points in a sentences or two.
Very good, Genaro. Thank you. Okay, children, summarize. After we read a part of a text or a story or an article, okay, you can summarize what you read. You can summarize. Okay, what is to summarize? To summarize means that you can reduce, okay? Summarize means to reduce, okay? To make it shorter. Summarize means that you can reduce a text or you can reduce an article or a story using your own words. Got it? Okay, that is to summarize. To summarize means to reduce after you read a text or after you read a story or an article, you can reduce that article or you can reduce that text using your own words, okay? Using your own words. And you can reduce the text in one sentence, okay? You can summarize what you read or you can reduce what you read in only one sentence, okay? So, what is the main point here? Okay, you need to remember that to summarize means to reduce a text in your own words. Reduce a text using your own words. And you can reduce a text in only one sentence, okay? So we are going to see some examples so you can understand better, okay? Now, I want to share with you another slide with some information that I think that is very helpful for you to understand this, okay? Pay attention. Okay, I'm going to share with you a PowerPoint slide. Just give me 1 minute with some information. Just let me see if I can see it. Okay. Yes, it's here. Okay. Can you see the slide? Just tell me yes. Can you see it?
Yes.
Thank you. Okay. So, Mayra, can you help me to read this slide?
Yes.
Thank you, my dear.
How to find the main idea of a passage.
Of a passage,
identify the topic. Summarize the...
Summarize?
Summarize the part, the page in
the
your
passage?
Own words. Check the first and last sentence. Look for repetition of ideas.
Good, Mayra. Thank you. Good job. Okay, children. In this slide, you have 4 points that you can check about how to find the main idea of a passage. Do you remember that we saw that the main idea is the most important idea, okay? But this information, it's also helpful for you to understand what is to summarize, okay? The slide says, to find the main idea of a passage, first, you have to identify the topic of the text. The topic means what is the theme? What is the text about? Or what is the article about? Okay, you need to identify first what is the article about. Okay, that is to identify the topic. Then you have to summarize the passage in your own words. Okay, here you have the word summarize. Look, summarize the passage. That means that you have to reduce the passage in your own words. Your own word means what you understood about the text or what you understood about the article. Then you have to check the first and the last sentence of the article. Why? Because usually the first and the last sentences in an article or in a text, they have the most important information from the text in the first and in the last sentences. So that's why you need to check very carefully the first sentence and the last sentence. And finally, you have to look for repetition of ideas. Okay, this means that you can see in a text or in an article the same idea several times, but with different words. So you can see the same idea several times. That is a repetition of an idea. So you have to look for repetition of ideas, okay? Good. So this information is to find the main idea. But I want you to understand what is to summarize, okay? And to find the main idea, you also need to summarize. You need to reduce the passage or to reduce the text, okay? Good. So, do you understand this, children? Yes? Okay, so now we're going back. We're going back to the student book again to answer an activity related to how can you summarize, okay? Just give me a moment, please. Just give me a moment, none of this. Sorry. Okay, I need to go to, sorry, I need to go to the, sorry, I need to go to the,
La maestra abandonó la reunión.
Sí, dijo que...
Ahorita regresa, no debe de tardar, chiquillos. Mientras aprovecho para saludarlos, soy la licenciada Vicky. Espero que se encuentren muy bien. Aquí los estoy viendo cómo están trabajando.
Hola.
Ok, veo a quienes están mueve y mueven la silla, quienes están jugando, entonces aquí estoy, pero los veo bien trabajadores a todos. Gracias, entonces ahorita regresa la mi, no debe de tardar, ¿ok? Yo también voy a aprovechar para felicitarlos. Están todos con el micro apagado, la cámara encendida. Muchas felicidades. Lo están haciendo muy, muy bien, chiquillos. Aunque hay algunos que no tienen muchas ganas, ¿verdad?, de estar en la clase.
Yes, I'm here again.
Ya regresó la Miss.
Okay, right now, let's continue. I'm going to share the student book with you. Okay, can you see it?
Yes.
Or no?
Yes.
Good. Okay. Now you are going to summarize. Okay. You have two texts or you have two paragraphs. Okay. Now you're going to summarize the paragraphs. Marcelo, can you read the instruction, please?
Read the paragraphs. Summarize what you read in a sentence.
Thank you, Marcelo. Okay, children, so listen up. You have to read the paragraphs, both paragraphs, paragraph one and paragraph two, and you have to summarize. You have to reduce, you have to summarize the text or the paragraphs in one sentence, okay? Summarize what you read in a sentence, only in one sentence. Okay, let's see if, Gustavo, can you read the paragraph one, please? Thank you.
Yes.
Camera in the car. Her father came out of the house with two paintings. Both are you ready for our fishing trip, Sandra? Yes, that. We're back, Sandra. I hope we can catch Tony Diner.
Tonight's. Repeat, Gustavo. Tonight's dinner. Very good, Gustavo. Thank you. So, listen up, children. Thank you, Gustavo. Sandra packed her sleeping bag, backpack, and camera In the car. Okay, Sandra packed her sleeping bag, her backpack, and her camera in the car. Her father came out of the house with two fishing poles. Fishing poles, cañas de pescar in Spanish, fishing poles. Her father came out of the house with two fishing poles. Are you ready for our fishing trip, Sandra? He asked. Her father asked. And Sandra says, yes, Dad, replied Sandra. I hope we can catch tonight's dinner. So there is the paragraph, children. Now you need to summarize, you need to reduce what you read in one sentence. Summary. Sandra and her dad are, okay, who wants to complete the sentence? Because you need to summarize in one sentence the paragraph. So who wants to complete the sentence? You can try. You can try. You can. I know you can do it. Sandra and her dad are. What are they going to do?
Sir, can I do it?
Yes, Emiliano. You can.
Sandra and her dad are going to a day of fishing trip.
Excellent. Good, Emiliano. Very good. Sandra and her dad are going, okay, completing your book. Take your pencil and complete it. Complete it in your book. Complete the sentence. Sandra and her dad are going to, or as Emiliano says, are going out or are going to a fishing trip. And you see, you summarize the paragraph in one sentence. Sandra and her dad are going to a fishing trip. You summarize what you read in one sentence. Sandra and her dad are going to a fishing trip. Got it? Excellent. Now, I need another volunteer. Okay, Jacqueline. Paragraph 2, Jacqueline, please.
Fred helped his mother take the sandwich and drinks out of the car. Fred's father spread the picnic blanket out on the grass. Fred couldn't wait to eat their picnic lunch. Suddenly, dark clouds appeared in the sky. In a few minutes, it began to rain. Fred and his parents gathered the food and blanket and ran
to the car. Excellent, Jacqueline. Thank you. So this is another paragraph that you need to summarize. You need to reduce this paragraph in one sentence. Okay, sorry. Let me erase this. Okay? So, listen up again. Fred helped his mother take the sandwiches and drinks out of the car. Fred's father spread means To open, okay? Spread the picnic blanket. Blanket in Spanish means mantel, okay? Fred's father spread the picnic blanket out on the grass. On the grass. Grass. Césped. Zacate. Fred's father spread the picnic blanket out on the grass. Fred couldn't wait to eat their picnic lunch. I don't know, maybe he was so hungry. So suddenly, in Spanish, suddenly means de repente, suddenly, dark clouds appear in the sky. Dark clouds, that means black clouds appear in the sky. And when dark clouds appear in the sky, that means that it's going to rain. So suddenly dark clouds appear in the sky. In a few minutes, it began to rain. Psh, it began to rain. Fred and his parents gathered the food. Gather means to pick it up, recoger, juntar. Fred and his parents gathered the food and the blanket and ran to the car because it began to rain. Okay? Now, summarize what you read in a sentence. Try to do it. All the information from the paragraph, summarize the information in one sentence. Who wants to try? And I can help you. If you are having troubles or problems, I can help you. But don't be afraid to try it.
Me, yo me lo sé.
Excuse me?
Yo.
Who are you?
Valeria.
Okay, Valeria, yes. Okay, Valeria, so. You may start to say the sentence.
Fred and his parents.
Okay, give me a minute. Give me a minute, Valeria. But it's too big. Okay, Fred and his parents
were on a picnic.
Uh-huh.
But it wasn't to rain.
Correct. Is correct, Valeria. Good. Good job. Fred and his parents were in a picnic and it began to rain, for example. Okay? So I'm going to write down the sentence. I'm going to write down the sentence in the chat because I don't know why the letters are too big. Just let me check if I can change it. But okay, Fred and his parents, it's too big, were in a picnic. Fred and his parents were in a picnic and then it began to rain. That is one sentence. You summarize all the information from the paragraph in one sentence. Children, I'm going to write down the sentence in the chat because the letters, I don't know why the letters are too big. Let me write down the sentence in the chat so you can see it. Okay, just give me. Okay, I'm going to write down the sentence in the chat. Okay, the sentence, Valeria, can you repeat the sentence, please? Fred? Open your microphone, Valeria. Good.
Fred and his parents were on a picnic about it began to rain.
Okay. Good, Valeria. Look, Valeria, look at the chat. Fred and his parents were on a picnic and suddenly it began to rain. Okay? Let me share with you the sentence. Fred and his parents were on a picnic and suddenly it began to rain. So, good? So, thank you, Valeria. So, you summarize what you read in one sentence. Okay, children? Okay, we have 5 minutes now. We have 5 minutes to check the words in context. Okay, so Eric, can you help me, Eric, to read the words in context, activity E, please?
Yes.
Thank you.
Delicate.
Pounded. Pounded.
Footsteps.
Repeat. Footsteps.
Footsteps.
Okay, one more time, Eric. Repeat after me. Delicate.
Delicate.
Bump. Pounded.
Pounded.
Footsteps.
Footsteps.
Okay, children, now I want you. Yes, it's kind of difficult to say, right? It's not easy to pronunciate. The correct pronunciation is footsteps. Okay, good, Eric. Now, children, I want you to go to the dictionary that is at the back of your student book and look for those words. The first one is delicate. Go to the letter D. Okay, go to letter D. And who wants to read the meaning? Delicate is an adjective. Delicate. Who wants to read the meaning? When we say that something is delicate, what is that?
Teacher, me.
Who are you?
Mariana.
Okay, Mariana. Excellent. Delicate, Mariana. Adjective.
Delicate. Easy to break or damage.
Thank you, Mariana. Very good. So, when we say that something is very delicate, that means that it's easy to break or damage. For example, a vase or a glass vase is delicate because it's easy to break or it's easy to damage. Okay? Very good, Mariana. Thank you. Remember to underline the word, underline the meaning with your highlighter. Underline the word and the meaning. It's important. Okay? Good. Now, the second one is bump.
Me.
Well, in your dictionary, the word appears as bump, but it's the same. Okay, who are you?
Me.
Who are you?
Ethan.
Okay, Ethan, go ahead. Bump.
Bug.
where to hit someone or somebody something when you are moving to hit a part of your body against something fast.
Very good, Ethan. Excellent. Thank you. Excellent. Yes. So, bump is the same as bumped because here in the book is in past. It's the same word, but in the book is in past. Okay? But it's the same. Okay? It's a verb. It's an action. Bump. To hit someone. To hit someone or something when you are moving. Maybe so you can move and you can hit a person or you can hit an item or an object. That is to bump. To hit someone or something when you're moving, when you are moving. Or to hit a part of your body, against something that is hard, okay? That is bump, or in this case, bump it. Okay, the next one, pounded.
Mr. ¿puedo participar?
Yes, who are you?
Megan.
Yes, Megan, pounded. Well, in the book appears as pound.
Pound.
Yes, it's a verb, it's an action.
To beat something with a heavy tool to make in soft or like powder.
Okay, thank you, Megan. Correct. Pound is to beat something. It's similar to hit, but to beat is when you do it several times. To beat something with a heavy tool to make it soft or like powder. Look, I have it here. I wrote the meaning so you can understand better. Pound, it's something like batir. In Spanish, pound is like batir. Okay, like batir, to hit something several times.
Also avisar, teacher.
Yes, Emiliano, it's correct. Yes, Emiliano, it's correct. Your observation is correct. Okay, children, turn off your microphones. Okay, Luis Antonio, footsteps. Please.
Known the sound of a person walking.
Thank you, Luis. Footsteps. Footsteps is the sound of a person walking. Footsteps. Got it? Is the sound of a person walking. In Spanish, it's something like pisadas. Clack, 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 clack. Okay, is the sound of a person walking. Excellent. Children, well, it's time to end our session, but I want to ask you for an activity. I want you to copy these four words. I want you to copy these four words in context in your English notebook, please. So, prepare a new page in your English notebook and the title is Words in Context, okay? And write down the four words in context with the meaning, the word and the meaning, okay? And don't forget the final lines. Okay, So, I'm going to check the attendance. I'm going to check the attendance. So when you hear your name, just say present, and then you may leave. Okay? Alejandra. Adame. Just say
present.
Good, Alejandra. Thank you. Bye. And remember the activity. Copy the words in context in your English notebook. Rodolfo.
Present.
Good, Rodolfo. See you. Bye. Okay. Isaac.
Present.
Good, Isaac. Bye. Gustavo.
Present.
Present. Excellent. Bye.
Bye.
Monica?
Present.
Okay, bye, Monica. Thank you. Marco Kamal?
Present.
Good, Marco.
Bye. Estamos en clase.
See you at 9. The next session is at 9:45. At 9:45. It's a spelling session. Okay. Mayra?
Present.
Good, Mayra. Bye. Christian.
Present.
Good, Christian. Bye. Mateo.
Present.
Okay, Mateo. Bye. Ethan.
Present.
Good, Ethan. Bye.
Bye.
Megan.
Present.
Good, Megan. See you.
Bye.
Bye. Carol.
Present.
Good, Carol. See you. Eric. Just say present, Eric.
Present. Miss, es que no te escuchaba, te veía trabada ahí.
Ah, it's because of the internet. Okay, Eric. Bye, Eric. Sofía Elizabeth.
Present.
Good, Sofía. Bye.
Bye.
Hania.
Present.
Good, Hania. See you.
Bye.
Bye, Emiliano.
Present. See you
good,
later.
Emiliano. Yes, see you in a moment. Okay? Bye, Emiliano. Jacqueline.
Present.
Very good, Jacqueline. See you. Bye. Daniela Fernanda.
Present.
Good, Danielita. Excellent. Bye. Mariana.
Present.
Very good, Mariana. Bye.
Bye.
Marco Antonio Navarro.
Present.
Very good, Marco. Bye.
Bye.
Maximiliano.
Present.
Good, Maximiliano. Bye.
Bye.
Samantha. Open your microphone, Samantha. Okay. Just turn it on, Samantha, your microphone. Turn it on. Turn it on. Okay, Okay, don't worry, Samantha. Just show me your thumb up. Say like this. Excellent, Samantha. See you in a moment, okay? Bye. Marcelo. Present. Good, Marcelo. Genaro. Wow, my God.
Present.
Okay. See you. Bye, Genaro. Valeria. Good, Valeria.
Present.
See you. Bye, Regina.
Bye.
Good.
Present.
Bye. Luis Antonio.
Present.
Good, Luis. Excellent. See you.
Bye.
Bye. Daniela Vasquez. Very good, Chilita. See you. Bye. Excellent. And